ओके, लेट्स गो टू आस्था एंड लेट्स लर्न अबाउट रूबी. गो एड आस्था.
कलर कर दो सर,
योर कैमरा इज नॉट विजिबल.
इट्स ओपन ऑलरेडी. आई कैन स्टार्ट माय कैमरा.
नॉट एबल टू सी दैट. यू कैन जस्ट क्लोज एंड ओपन अगेन.
नाउ
या नाउ इट्स ओके.
ओके सर. तो रूबी लेजर, रूबी इज एन एआई टू ओसी क्रिस्टल व्हिच कंटेन्स 0.05% ऑफ CrSO3. सॉलिड स्टेट लेजर इज एन एग्जाम्पल विच डिस्क्राइब्स अ रूबी लेजर. द रूबी लेजर इज अ थ्री लेवल लेजर. द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ रूबी लेजर इज इन एन एक्टिव मीडियम एज रूबी प्रोसेस कॉल्ड स्पॉन्टेनियस इमिशन प्रोड्यूसेस लाइट. द लाइट प्रोड्यूस विद इन द लेजर मीडियम विल बाउंस बैक एंड फोर्थ बिटवीन द टू मिरर्स. This stimulates other electron to fall into the ground state by releasing light energy. The output in wavelength of a ruby laser is 6943 angstrom. In ruby laser, the pumping corresponds to nearly 5600 angstrom. Thank you, sir.
Quite good. You have explained Ruby in short very nicely. Anybody has any question what she has told? You should be very specific. Whatever she has told, you can ask question to that related portion. No? Okay. Thanks, Asta. Let's go to now Akanksha.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Am I audible, sir?
Yes, you are audible. You'll be presenting or okay. You'll
Am
be
I visible?
Yeah.
Yes,
you
yes.
are visible.
Yes. Yeah. So today I'm going to tell about ruby laser. A ruby laser is a solid state laser that uses a synthetic ruby crystal and its gain medium. Ruby laser produces pulses of a coherent visible light at a wavelength of 694.3 nanometer, which is a deep red color. Ruby has a very broad and powerful absorption bands in a visual spectrum at 400 nanometer and 500 nanometer, and a very long fluorescence lifetime of 3 milliseconds. This allows it for a very high energy pumping. Since the pulse duration can be much longer than with other materials, while ruby has a very wide absorption profile, its conversion efficiency is much lower than other mediums.
Quite good. Most important thing, conversion efficiency, lifetime, you have explained. And synthetic ruby.
Yes, synthetic ruby means it is made up of melting aluminium oxide that contains a trace of chromium.
Why do you use synthetic ruby? Why not natural ruby? Think over it. I don't want the answer right now. Okay.
Yes.
The question in Asta's presentation, I just forgot to tell. She told that it is 0.05% of chromium in aluminium oxide. So whether this is percentage means what? Is it something like? I don't want to tell the answer. So. What is this 0.05%? Percent means atom to atom, or what are the percentage you are talking about? Okay, Gunjan is asking, can we present the presentation PPT? Yes, you can. If you have, you can. It's very good. Okay, roll number 7. Okay, accepted. Okay, next is roll number 3, Amit.
हेलो सर.
या
सर, मैं दो तीन बात दोनों तीन रोल नंबर के बाद दे सकता हूँ क्या?
क्या हुआ, कुछ प्रॉब्लम?
सर मैं बाहर आ गया.
हाँ,
बाहर आ गया मैं. बाहर
बाहर है. ओके.
हाँ सर.
हाँ तो बाकी लोग जितने भी हैं वहां पे उनको भी बता ठीक है। ओके ओके आई जस्ट कीप रोल नंबर 3 ऑन होल्ड। ओके रोल नंबर 4।
यस सर।
या तो यू वांट टू प्रेजेंट और यू वांट टू टेल। ओके गुड वेलकम
रूबी
अंकित।
लेजर, यस सर। रूबी लेजर इज अ सॉलिड स्टेट लेजर। इट इज अ 3 लेवल सॉलिड स्टेट लेजर। द रूबी लेजर कंसिस्ट ऑफ 3 एसेंशियल कंपोनेंट्स: पंप सोर्स, गेन मीडियम एंड रेजोनेटिंग कैविटी। इन वर्किंग इन अ रूबी लेजर, अ सिंगल क्रिस्टल ऑफ रूबी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ सिलेंडर एक्ट एज अ लेजर मीडियम और एक्टिव मीडियम। द लेजर मीडियम इन रूबी लेजर इज मेड अप ऑफ होस्ट ऑफ सफायर विच इज डोप्ड विद स्मॉल अमाउंट्स ऑफ क्रोमियम आयन्स। क्रोमियम गिव्स रूबी इट्स कैरेक्टरिस्टिक पिंक और रेड कलर। रूबी क्रिस्टल हैज द एटम्स विच विल इमिट फोटॉन्स। फ्लैश ट्यूब प्रोवाइड्स एनर्जी टू पुट एटम्स इन एक्साइटेड स्टेट। स्पॉन्टेनियस एमिशन क्रिएट्स फोटॉन ऑफ करेक्ट फ्रिक्वेंसी एम्प्लीफाइड बाय स्टिमुलेटेड एमिशन ऑफ एक्साइटेड एटम्स। थैंक यू सर।
ओके अंकित इज इट योर फर्स्ट टाइम ऑन कैमरा?
यस सर।
ओके सो क्वाइट गुड द कॉन्फिडेंस वाज वेरी नाइस बट इट सीम्स लाइक यू आर रीडिंग। अंकित यू आर रीडिंग और यू जस्ट रिमेम्बर्ड एवरीथिंग एंड देन यू प्रेजेंटेड?
I just present.
Okay, so it was looking like you were reading, but I was not sure. So next time, just focus on camera, and then you can take. Okay, the one thing what you have told is resonant cavity. Anybody
Yes.
has any idea what is resonant cavity?
Sir,
Now, if you don't, then it's okay. It is not compulsory. Okay, so the fourth point is resonant cavity. You can just search on it and then you can tell me. Okay,
okay sir.
This is for all, not for Ankit only. This is for all. Okay, next is Anurag.
Yes sir.
Yeah.
Sir, is it visible?
Yeah.
Ruby laser is a solid state 3-level laser. The principle of the working of the ruby laser: most of the Cr3 positive ions are situated in the ground level, and after the flash is generated on the ruby rod, the most of the Cr3 positive ions get absorbed to the excited level at E3. Hence, it is called as optical pumping. Now, since the lifetime of the excited state, that is 10^-8 seconds, is very high and unstable, so most of the ions are non-radiative transition and goes to the E2, that is second energy level, that is metastable, and from that metastable, the number of Cr3 positive ions goes increasing at the E2 level and side by side decreasing on the E1 level. And so this is thus the population inversion takes place between metastable and ground level, and due to spontaneous emission, the red color laser is come out. That is, thank you.
It is not spontaneous, it is stimulated emission because of we get the laser. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Certainly we'll need spontaneous emission initially. So you have talk about Cr3 plus ions. Okay. So why we need Cr3 plus ions? And can't we go for example, purely chromium? I mean, for example, if you are using chromium oxide, then go for a chromium oxide. Why you need to dope the chromium into the aluminium oxide? Think about it. And secondly,
yes,
what is a flash? you talk about flash. What is a flash? Have you ever seen flash or flash lamp? देखा है कभी? किसी ने देखा है? Anyone? नहीं? आपने फ्लैश नहीं देखा? आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट द मूवी और मूवी कैरेक्टर. फ्लैश इज समथिंग दैट यू यू यूज ड्यूरिंग द कैमरा फ्लैश. यस, वेरी राइट प्रांजल. विच इज गिविंग द लाइट फॉर शॉर्ट टाइम. फ्लैश आता है, आपको फोटो खींचता है, ठीक है. सिमिलरली इन रूबी लेजर यू आर नॉट गिविंग द पंपिंग कंटिन्यूअसली. इट इज इम्पॉसिबल. यू कैनॉट पंप द रूबी लेजर कंटिन्यूअसली. सो वॉट यू डू, यू गिव द फ्लैश. सो यू गिव द लाइट्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ फ्लैश. वाई डू यू गिव द फ्लैश? थिंक अबाउट इट. ओके, नेक्स्ट रोल नंबर 6, अर्पित. You have some network issue? Okay, next, Ashwini. Roll number 8, Ashwini, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, what would you like to tell about Ruby Laser? You can either present or you can just tell us orally.
Sorry, sir. Can you repeat?
You can tell orally or you can just present if you are having any diagram presentation. So you can switch on your camera and you can tell us about Ruby Laser if you are not presenting. It seems there is some issue. Okay, let's go to Atharva. Yeah, Atharva.
Sir, am I audible? Ruby laser was the first laser to be made functionally built by Theron Mamin in 1960. The device was created out of the concept of an optical measure. Ruby is one of the few solid state laser that produce light in the visible range of spectrum. The lasing at 694 nanometers in a deep red color. Ruby laser most often consists of a ruby rod that must be pumped with very high energy. The photons are projected from ground state to the excited state, which is in third level, and when due to the population inversion we get a very short pulses through which the laser is formed. And when the population inversion is completed, so we don't get laser. That's why we get a pulse laser.
Quite good, Atharva. You have pointed out one thing, that is optical measure, and secondly, why we get the pump laser. So that was explained very nicely, that we cannot get the population inversion for long time. So you have to pump it in pulse, and you will get the output as pulse. Okay, quite good, quite nice. I think you were reading some portion, but you were telling some portion. Am I right?
I have written some bullet points from the previous lecture, so that's in written in notes, so that I have read.
Oh, okay. That is good. That is good. So keeping points is okay. That is not an issue. Quite good. Keep it up. Next, Chaitanya. Chaitanya, are you there?
Hello?
Yeah, Chaitanya.
Okay, so Ruby laser is a solid state laser.
Just. इसको क्या बोलते हैं, हॉरिजॉन्टल और वर्टिकल?
हॉरिजॉन्टल।
तो आप ऐसे दिख रहे हैं। आई डोंट नो हाउ टू चेंज दिस। यस, नाउ इट इज वेरी गुड। ओके, हाँ, लैंडस्केप। यस, आई फॉरगॉट द टेक्निकल वर्ड। ओके, नाउ पोर्ट्रेट।
ओके, सो रूबी लेजर इज सॉलिड स्टेट लेजर, इट इज अ थ्री लेवल लेजर। So the most important condition for obtaining the laser light is that we need to have the population inversion. So in case of ruby laser, it is obtained using the optical pumping, which optical pumping is nothing but the when the incident light is used to excite electron from a lower energy level to higher energy level. So thus the population inversion is obtained in case of ruby laser. So from when the electrons are excited from ground state to higher excited state, then it is down to the metastable state from where the pulse laser is obtained. This is not this ruby laser is not capable of maintaining the long continuous laser. So hence it gives the pulse laser only.
Very nice. I think there was some technical problem, maybe a network issue. So there was some what you can say noise, but quite okay. You were audible and very nicely told that everybody now knows that ruby laser is a solid state laser. Okay, so that quite good. Overall very good. And you are not red, I suppose.
No, sir.
Okay. Quite good. Okay, keep the confidence up, and
yes,
let's go to now next participant, Chanchal.
Am I audible, sir?
Yes, go ahead. So you'll be presenting, or you'll be telling orally?
Orally telling, sir.
Okay.
Good afternoon, sir. Ruby laser, in ruby laser, a solid material is used, that is a rod which is round with some coil. It was the first type of laser invented by Manman in 1960. Ruby mineral consists of aluminium oxide and chromium, which is 0.05%. It gives a red color after doping it. Ruby laser has one rod, which is a coil between, and it has two ends. and both end are silvered, and one is partially silvered, to which rays or we can say laser come out. There are few application of ruby laser in industrial use, to drill tiny holes in hard material, welding and machining, and heavy localized heating. In everyday life, we can use in barcode reader. We can find that device in mall or at a Sevagram hospital. It is used to produce holograms. I think it is also used in CD players. It is also used in surgical uses like bloodless surgery or etc.
Quite good. Only thing that I wanted to tell that the applications are not of ruby laser, they are of helium neon laser. Mostly helium neon laser is used in the barcode reader, okay, or the semiconductor lasers. But mostly ruby laser is high power, so it will not be used in scanning the barcodes. It will burn, okay. And of course, it is quite, nobody has told me what is the size of the rod up till now. Okay.
Sir, it is.
Yeah.
0.5 centimeter to 1 centimeter.
No, I feel like, yeah, Gunjan says 5 centimeter. Yes. That is the approximate size of 5 centimeter. Making this crystal, taking out this crystal is very difficult. Okay. And the first question what I asked was, what is this 0.05%? So, in Telegram, Asta has replied that it is by weight of, I think, Cr2O3. It should be Cr2O3.
CrSO3? Yes.
What is S?
I'm fine on Google.
I think that should be Cr2O3. Or it should be something like, because this is not sulfate, chromium sulfate, SO3. SO3 will be sulfate. Okay. So just check once again, but it is weight by weight. So if you have a weight of say 100 gram of say aluminum oxide, then how much chromium oxide or chromium ions you are depositing? It is 0.05 gram. So small, okay? So that is what it is, yeah, called a doping. Agar wo almost 50-50 ho jaye, then it will be considered as mixture or it will be compound depending upon the reaction. Have you ever seen the doping in your real life? Bahut hi chhota sa part aap kisi dusre isme dal dete, and then the property of the material changes suddenly. Kabhi dekha aapne? Dekha hai lekin pata nahi, isi ko doping kehte hai. Nahi? Isliye main baar baar bolta hu ki if you want to learn physics, you should know the kitchen. Jalebi khaiye kabhi?
Yes, sir.
So, jalebi mein color kitna dalte hain? Maan lo ki 1 kilo jalebi aapko, ha? Thoda sa matlab kitna? 1 kilo jalebi agar banani hai aapko, to usme kitna color dalenge?
1/2 teaspoon or 1 teaspoon?
Yeah, even less than that is enough. Usko color dena hai bas. Food color jo hota hai na, bahut kam dalte hain. Even in case of say holy color colors, so that is also, agar aapko pani colorful karna hai to aap kitna dalenge? Thoda sa, ek chamach, bahut ho gaya. As compared to 20 liters of water, is very less. It is similar to doping. So the color has changed suddenly because of very small amount of foreign material. Okay, are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
But if you are taking two materials, You said something, Pranjal?
Sir, Ujala Neel.
हाँ उजाला नील, वाह वेरी गुड वेरी नाइस, एक ड्रॉप बस बहुत हो गए राइट. बट इफ यू आर टेकिंग ऑलमोस्ट ऑलमोस्ट 30-40% और 10% देन इट इज नॉट अ डोपिंग, इट इज अ मिक्सचर और इट इज अ कंपाउंड, इट डिपेंड्स रिएक्शन हो रहा है तो कंपाउंड, नहीं हो रहा है मिक्सचर, ठीक है तो उसे कहते हैं मिक्सचर, ठीक है. ओके coming back to our list, now we have Chanchal ke baad hai Chirayu. Chirayu, are you there?
Sir, am I audible?
Yes, you are audible, you are visible.
Okay sir, good afternoon. A ruby laser is a solid state laser that use a ruby laser is a solid state laser that used synthetic ruby crystal as it gain medium. The first working laser was a ruby laser that was made by my man at on 16th May 1960. And the ruby laser produce pulse of visible light at the wavelength of 694.3 nanometer, which is a deep in red color, and typically laser pulse length on the order of milliseconds, in the order of their milliseconds. Thank you, sir.
Very nice. It's Theodore Maimon, 1960. But you have mentioned the date also. That is quite good. It seems that you were reading, I suppose. So next time try, you can try orally presenting, okay? So again, somebody talk about synthetic ruby. Why we use synthetic ruby and not the natural ruby? That is the question. That is open ended. Okay. Now we'll go to roll number 14. Devansh.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Am I clearly visible and audible?
Yes, yes.
So, can I start?
Yeah, go ahead.
So a ruby laser is a solid state laser that uses a synthetic ruby crystal, and it as it gains medium, typical ruby laser's pulses lengths are on the order of milliseconds. A ruby laser most often consists of a ruby rod that must be pumped with a very high energy, usually from a flash tube, to achieve a population inversion. Ruby laser is one of a few solid state lasers that produce light in the visible range of spectrum, lasing at 694 nanometers in a deep red color with a very narrow line width of 0.5 nanometers. The ruby laser is a three level solid state laser. The active laser medium is a synthetic ruby rod that is energized through optical pumping, typically by xenon flash tubes, while ruby lasers are a very wide absorption profile. Its conversion efficiency is much lower than the other mediums. In early examples, the rod's end has to be polished with great precision, such that the end of the rod were flat within a quarter of a wavelength of the output light and parallel to each other within a few seconds of arc. Ruby laser also absorbs some of the light as it raising wavelengths. Thank you, sir.
You are given the details of how these ends should be polished, and
yes,
polish to the precision of how much? Lambda by 4.
Sorry, sir.
What you said? Polish in the precision of?
Sir, polish in the precision says that they are narrow, parallel to the arc within a few seconds.
Okay. So, what do you understand by a second here?
Few seconds, I think a very small period, like milliseconds or nanoseconds.
No. What is the relation between second and this polishing?
Sir, I don't know.
Okay, no problem. That is what I am trying to understand, whether you know it or not. Okay, it's okay. This second is not related to time. First thing, it is related with the
angle.
Yes, it is with angle. And how many seconds make?
Sir, yeah, a very small unit of, it's a very small unit of angle. We get radian, minutes, and then seconds.